Hi guys, picked this one up in a charity shop quite a while ago. Was expecting to try and do it with one of my grandsons, but we've never got round to it, so I'm going to do it myself. It says, build a sports car radio controlled. With a couple of happy looking chaps on it. Certainly an interesting hairstyle up there. Anyway, I have had a look in it. It doesn't look like it's been started. I think somebody might have had a peek at it and then decided not to do it. And it is radio controlled, but it looks to me like it's simply forwards and backwards. It's just two buttons there. 49 megahertz. Looks like the bag's been opened, but I think everything's in there. Body shell. Check there's nothing. Oh, screwdriver. Well, that was worth looking. Okay, so we have a box, which I'll put to one side. Radio control gear, body shell, bits and pieces, instructions. Looks like it might be four-wheel drive. Oh, we'll find out in a minute. A few screws. Tires. Oh, they're nice soft. Soft rubbery tires. They're rubbery. Are we missing a piece? So look at the picture. Says they've got numbers on them. Oh yes, they are numbered. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. That looks good. Remove a component, twist it back and forth till it separates from the frame. Ask an adult to help you by removing any remnants of the plastic tabs that connect the pieces to the frame with a knife or scissors. Right, well, I'll consider myself to be an adult at the moment. Whenever the word click appears in the instruction manual, the specified piece must be pressed firmly into place until a click is heard. Right. Okay. So, part number one. Goes into part number five. Okay. goes through the back of here. Is there a right way and a wrong way? Looks like it goes that way. And that piece. Yeah, that goes in there. Right. Click. Did that. Why does that say TS17? Oh, I'm not going to do the stickers. Well, I'm not going to do the stickers. Oh, there they are. Alright, maybe I will do the stickers. Oh, they're a bit wrinkled. No, I'm not going to do the stickers. They've lost their sticky. So I'd have to glue them. Alright. We won't be doing stickers at the moment. That says X18. Just trying to see if there's any mention what those. Nope, I don't see anything that tells you what that TS17 and that X18 means. It is four-wheel drive though. I know what this is. This is one of those ones that goes in a, it's not a slot car, it's a guided track. That's why you only need forwards and backwards. Because you just race it around this guided track and it has little bits on the front. That's, yeah, like sideways pointing wheels that rub against the sides of the track. I've had something similar a long time ago. Mind you, I've had this kit for quite a long time. Right, put that out of the way because we're not going to put the stickers on it. This piece. The right way round. How can we tell? Yeah, that's the right way round. You've got some oil that's leaking. Right, that one is gonna go along there. But we might have to put the gear in place. I'm going to go in there. I'm just going to go there. That one. This one go there, but how can we tell which way round? I'm going to have to look at that a bit closer. Still not clear. I think that's a choice of speeds, depending on which way round that goes. Not sure. No, it can't be. That's got to go in. It's got to go in there somewhere. Gear, it's got to be that one. That makes a bit more sense. That one's going to go in there like that. Yes. So that one. Is in there. Right, so that goes in quite a bit later. Right, so we've got those gears in place. Grease the gears. That used to be wood if there was any left in there. Oh God. Came out in one lump. Right, next. Look like they go either way. They do feel nice. I'm not aware of any clubs that do this sort of racing in the UK. They might do. I mean, I'm not really up on that sort of thing anyway. But I think it's Japan that these are popular. Right, that's the wheels. I'll need a piece of wood in a minute. Okay, so we need a wheel, which is going to go on there. Make sure we don't push right through and stab our fingers, which I have done in the past. Push too hard and it's gone right through the plastic and stuck the axle in my finger. Oh, it's got a little bump on it too. Right, so it's one of them, and one of these little brass things, and a, is it one of those washers? No, it isn't, it's one of these. Part six, yep, these ones. That fits on there. So that's going to go through there, and through there, and then that one that I've just done goes that way round with the brass on the outside, and then the wheel, and then push them together. Same again, push that on there. These axles are actually hexagonal. Obviously to help them grip. So, brass thing goes on there. Top, push that home, yep. Do the other one. Right, done that. Oh, I was supposed to grease them before I put them on. That wasn't very clear. come off again easily? Yes, they do. Them off again. Yes. Right, nicely greased. Put that to one side a minute. Now we've got to do part 7, this one. That one goes. There. It says click. Oh, I see. Right, over there, under there, and then that bit clicks on there. Yeah. My stomach just rumbled. Did you hear that? I apologise if that offends anybody, but I'm afraid a fact of life. Okay, which of these ones is next? They all look the same. That one. That's gonna go. Let's see, that's gonna click on the end. Yes, it did. That one unclicked. All right. Motor. Motor. Small one there. And this. That goes in there. Oh, I see. the contacts on the motor are going to make contact with those bits of metal there. It just fell off again. So that's going to go in like that and click in place. Yes, very nice. And then this goes in here. That way round. It does say click. I didn't hear it click that time, but I can see where it's gone and it has clicked in place. Then this one with a bit of grease on it, it's going to go there with that one. That goes grease, grease, grease. It shows grease going on there. Oh, got a bit of fluff on there, we don't want that. Shows a bit of grease on there. So that's going to go that way round, yeah, that way round. Grease is actually picking up the fluff off the table now. Right, so that's in there. And then this part, part number 8. Doesn't want to come off. Get a bit of help. And that is going that way round. Come on, you stay where you're supposed to be. Over there. Yep, that's gone in place. Getting close. Number 15, this one. It's got to go there. I would say that way up. Yep. And which screws? Those ones? Yep. and a washer. We're getting a bit, we could do with moving the camera, couldn't we? Alright, apologise if you couldn't see what I was doing just now. That's asking a lot of that little screwdriver. Just the one. Right. Have I missed anything? Because we don't seem to have anything on there to stop that bit falling out. Maybe that comes later. Right. Part number 12. Going back a bit, I'm no. Okay. Part number 12. That piece. Part number 12. Goes like that. It's got to be like that. And then we need part number 11 to go on top, so they're going to fall off. That's 11. very nicely. Oh no, it's one of those things. One of those things where it's all going to fall apart when you try and do it. Right, hold that that way. That way. It's supposed to go click. Oh, that went click. Right, well, that was pain. And that goes up at this end. How can that be right? That's because I'm trying to get it in the wrong place. That's where it goes. Okay, that goes there. Oh, that's an on-off switch. Right. Off, I think. And then parts 3 and 4 go in there. This is part 3. Yes. This is part 4. Yes. Know whether that actually turns or not. Looks like it does. Part 10, that one. Goes in. Goes in where? There. Ah, that's where that receiver goes, in there. That thing. was completely wrong in what I thought it was. Now this piece and this piece. There. And this piece goes. That's the on-off switch then. Yes, off. On, off, on. Take that a bit closer. Yeah, we can see off and on there. Off, on. Part 13. Goes over the top of that to hold it all in place. And that's the bit I was worried about earlier because I couldn't see how that was going to hold in place. That goes under there. That's better. Nine. That's to hold the battery in place. Yep. Now we got these bits to go in. And of course these all want bits of grease on them as well. I think they were a bit mean on the grease, or it's all leaked away over the years that it's been in the box. So, through there. Where's the grease? Put the grease on there. That goes through there. That goes on there. And that screws on there. Bigger screwdriver than that. I'll get one in a minute. I'll just get them started so we know where we are.
be one washer short as well. Don't know how that's happened. Sorry you can't see what I'm doing, but I'm struggling a bit. That one started. Yep, we appear to be short of one washer. I cannot see what I'm doing, even with my glasses on. It doesn't help that it's all greased now and it's slipping around. Probably would have been better to have started the screws in the holes without the pulley in place, or wheel, or whatever you want to call it. Like this. Put that on there so we can actually see what we're doing. So we've at least got a thread started. And then try it with that. Yeah, I'm going to get a bigger screwdriver so I can finish that. Try that one. Is that going to be too big? Those got a flat head. Right, so got them on. Those could do a tightening up a bit more on the bottom as well. Right, done that. Now we need two AA batteries. Oh, receiver. Receiver. That way round. Okay. And then turn that. And that's lock it in place. That's us. Yeah, I think we've done it. So we need a 9-volt battery for there and two AA batteries for there. Right, a couple of AA batteries. That way around, that's going to go that way around. Hmm. 9-volt battery. Bit of a tight fit. So there now. Okay, it's on and off. Shall we try it before we put the cover on? Working. Oh, come on. What happened there? Seems to be a bit loose. Try again. Two. Okay. Okay, looks like it works. Cover. Goes on there. Slide it on the front, and that bit clicks on there. And clicks off again. Alright, didn't push it on far enough. It goes in there. That's better. Now, I think it's a shame that the stickers didn't work. And so they've just lost their sticky because they've been there for far too long. I don't know if it's had a date on it anywhere. Creative Toys Limited. Oh well. Well, we'll put it on the floor, but it does only go forwards and backwards because I don't have a suitable track for it to bash into and go round the bends. We'll go backwards so we can come forwards to the camera. Oh, range. Oh, well, I haven't got the aerial up. Right. There's obviously something sticking a bit on the gears because it's jamming occasionally. Yeah. Right, this is take two. It worked okay, but it was struggling. I took it apart again, cleaned the bearings or re-greased them, adjusted the pinion gear position, and it was still struggling. Put fresh batteries in it, and it seems a lot better. But that is all it does, forwards and backwards. So, well, it works. It actually looks quite nice, but limited to just forwards and backwards without the proper racetrack, it's a bit of a dead loss, to be honest. So, yep, job done. That'll do.
Thanks for watching. You'll find more information down in the video description. You might like to watch that video up there. And you might like to subscribe over there.